Well, hey, Kyle, thanks for writing. Here's an answer to you and everybody else involved down there in Chatterbox to your question. I guess you didn't expect such a major production in answering your question, but I'm not much into writing a blog. My blog, as you know, you've seen it, is a video blog, and so I thought, well, this is appropriate. I'll give you a video answer to the question, which is, what is your most unconventional but effective tip to help someone overcome public speaking nerves? Well, whether you call it nerves, or fear of speaking, or stress, or anxiety, or nervousness, or the jitters, I think it's all the same kind of feeling, even though it may emanate from a different place in each individual student. Okay, one of the phrases that I use repeatedly in my classes, in my blog, in some of the articles I've written, is that you don't learn to speak by reading a book. You learn to speak by speaking. And so consequently, I get my students up immediately on their feet, contributing something to the group. And the results are going to be somewhat predictable. I know that the majority of them, because they're in this particular kind of workshop, and I call my classes workshops, they're there because of exactly what you're talking about. They feel nervous. They feel stress. They have stage fright. They suffer with the fear of speaking, which I don't know about in Australia, but in America, surveys and polls say that 60 to 70% of Americans suffer with the fear of speaking. They say it's their number one fear, above being bitten by tigers and lions and bears. Well, I hate to disappoint you, but I don't have one particular magical answer to your question. I have developed a variety of approaches which I apply depending on how I size up the students' needs after I meet them and see them for the first time in front of the group. That said, I would suggest for you dealing with students that are younger, don't have this negative attachment to their feelings as long as adults do, which might be 20, 30 years in some cases, I would say one thing you could do would be to change the negative sounding words you use to describe their feelings. Reframe those words. Choose positive words. And I've got some suggestions for you. See, I think if you reframe the words from something negative to something positive, the students will respond in a more positive way more quickly. Now, for example, how about instead of stress, you choose the word anticipation? Well, anticipation of what? Anticipation of having a fun time. Or how about anxiety and change that to excitement? Excitement of what? Excitement at being able to perform in front of a group of people. That's pretty exciting. Or how about taking the word nerves, which you used in your question, and change that to fuel? Fuel for delivering your information at a high energy level, which we all know you have to do if you're going to bridge that physical distance between you, the speaker, and the audience that you're talking to. And then I wonder, why can't we change stage fright to stage power? Dr. Maxwell Maltz wrote years ago a book called Psycho-Cybernetics. A lot of people still think it's a preeminent study of human behavior. Anyway, he suggests that if a person elects a new behavior and repeats that behavior for 21 days, at the end of 21 days, that new behavior will become a habit. And I think he's got something there. I've tried it on myself years ago, and I saw a definite change in my attitude towards, of all things, an exercise program that I was involved in at the time. What I'm suggesting to you is that if it's true that a lot of people say that thoughts create reality, then instilling new thinking, new thoughts in the minds of your students may in fact produce new behavior. Give them new words, more positive words, to replace the older, typical negative words, and I think in a short period of time, they may let go of those feelings of negativity, recognize the feelings as something positive, which is what you want. Kyle and the people at Chatterbox, I hope this helps your program out. I'm always interested in new information, and I look forward to hearing from you and communicating with you in the future.